and welcome here to Copa America 2019. And for Argentina, it is make or break. They have to beat Qatar. They simply must win in this crucial end of group stage game at Copa America 2019. It's Group B. It's Qatar against Argentina. It's the full match preview with everything you need to know. Because for Argentina, for Lionel Messi, this is the last chance saloon. They cannot fail. They cannot make any more mistakes. And we're going to be talking about it all. And who could line up tomorrow in this crucial clash? It's coming right up. Stay right there. So, Qatar will face Argentina in the 55,000-seater Arena do Grêmio in Porto Alegre in Brazil, and certainly the native Brazilians will be wanting to see Argentina exit the tournament tomorrow night, and that is a genuine possibility right now. If Argentina don't get it right against Qatar, if they don't step up when it really, really matters, and it does right now for them, if they don't do that, they could be on their way out in the group stage, which at the start of this tournament was simply unthinkable. And this game, of course, will be played at exactly the same time as Colombia against Paraguay in the other match in this group. And that's basically just to ensure that no team here has any advantage of knowing exactly what they need to do in this final group match. And all will be decided after this final round here in Group B. For Argentina, though, their task, like I say, it is simple. Win. And win there with a capital W, because quite simply, they have to do that. They have to win if they want to advance to the knockout stages, which is what we all want for Argentina. That is where they should be. A team there, the historic nation of Argentina, the players they have, the quality they do have in that squad, and of course for Lionel Messi, we want to see Argentina there in the knockout stages. But to do that, they must win this game. If we look at the group right now, a win right here would likely propel them into second place in Group B, even though it would be their first win of Copa America 2019. Automatic qualification there will come if they finish second in Group B, but that's only providing that Paraguay don't upset the odds and beat Colombia in the other game. If Paraguay did happen to beat Colombia and Argentina did beat Qatar, though, they would likely still see themselves through to the knockout rounds as one of the two best placed third teams, because out of the three groups in total, two of the best placed third teams in those groups will also get through to the knockout stages. A draw, however, would mean disaster for Argentina, because a draw in this game against Qatar would see them finish behind Qatar there in Group B, and it would also likely see them finish behind Paraguay as well, which would see them finish bottom of their group here at Copa America, which, like I say, would be unthinkable at the start of this tournament. Even if Paraguay, though, did suffer a heavy defeat there against Colombia, Argentina could make their way up with a draw to finish third, but even then, it's unlikely that Argentina would finish as one of those two best-placed third teams overall. So to be honest, it's win or bust. Win this game and Argentina will be in the quarterfinals of Copa America. But like I say, with Argentina, when it really comes down to it, they do not have a good track record when they're under pressure. In these big, big moments, can they put it together? Can they come together as one, as a nation, as a group, as a team? That remains to be seen. And to be honest here, they're going to be up against a nation in Qatar who are very, very strong. They're up against the odds. They're certainly underdogs, but they will thrive under that. They've got a very good coach. They've got a good group of players here who can certainly play as a team, something that Argentina simply haven't mastered. And Qatar here will believe they have what it takes to cause a big upset in the tournament in this match. This is a big one. And before we do move on to the team that we could see tomorrow from Argentina for this crucial encounter, let's first of all take a look at their opponents on the night, which is going to be Qatar. And look at the quality, really, that we've seen from Qatar right the way through this Copa America campaign so far. Their first ever Copa America in their history. And I have to say this, they've done very, very well. They've really given a good account of themselves, and they've certainly enhanced their reputation as a national team ahead of the World Cup there in 2022. They were 2-0 down after 56 minutes in the opening game against Paraguay in that first group stage match, but it was almost the complete opposite there of Argentina. Qatar went 1-0 down, Qatar went 2-0 down. Even though they dominated the ball there in that first half of that game, they found themselves 2 goals down. Did they give up? Did they give in? Did their heads go down? Absolutely not. Qatar picked themselves back up. They got themselves back in the game. They got a goal back. It was a wonderful, wonderful strike there from long range from Ali. Phenomenal, phenomenal strike. Really fantastic goal from Qatar. After some really good build-up as well in that move there. And they got themselves back in the game. They made sure there, they got a result, they stuck together, they stood firm, and certainly look at their coach there, the Barcelona-born Felix Sanchez-Bas. He has done a wonderful job here with the Qatar national team. They pass the ball really well, they're organised, they all understand their roles. This right here is a team. And like I say, Argentina don't seem to know the meaning of that word. They're going to have to come together here to actually see off a structured team, an organised team, because that's here what Qatar have shown they are. Because even in their second game, when they came off there as second best to Colombia, it was only by a goal to nil. It was a very, very slender margins there, very narrow defeat. Colombia won, Qatar nil on the night. And again there, they really gave a good account of themselves. They played well, they still had good quality on the ball, they still showed some nice moves, they were a lot more defensive in that game. That's how I expect them to be against Argentina. They will sit back more, they won't have as much of the ball, they won't certainly look to dominate in this game. But when they do sit back, they are defensively solid, they're structured, they're organised. Colombia really did struggle to break them down. They threw on a number of strikers to try and actually get that goal, and it came only 4 minutes from the end of the game. Have Argentina got the bottle? Can Argentina handle that kind of pressure? If it takes them until the last 5 minutes to score a goal, do they have that kind of pressure there to rise to the occasion and step up there when it matters? Because they might need to be patient, they might need to hit back in this kind of game to get the result they need. But Argentina here have to prove they can come together as a team, as a collective, and actually win this game here. It may take individual quality, it may take a bit of luck, maybe some good fortune for Argentina. Whatever it takes though, they need to get that first goal, build on that, win this game. Because if they don't, we're not going to be seeing Argentina in the knockout stages. And this here, this is how they could line up tomorrow. Because this right here is one of two teams that we could see tomorrow from Lionel Scaloni. And believe me, he's got some massive, massive decisions to make. He's got to get it absolutely right in his team selection, in his structure of the team. And this here is one of the possible two teams that we are going to look at in today's video. Starting here with Armani, who's expected to retain his place there as the goalkeeper. Tagliafico at left back, Otamendi, Petzela, and then Casco coming in at right back in place there of Sarabia. That back four there is pretty much confirmed. That there is going to be the back four. One change at right back, I think certainly that has been enforced. Sarabia has not played well over the course of this tournament, and certainly Argentina needs something different in that kind of role. In the midfield here, in this first rumoured lineup, you've got Rodriguez holding alongside Paredes, Lo Celso there playing a central position, something that I definitely feel he needs to do. And then for the first time, could we see Paulo Dybala in the first team, in the starting lineup for Argentina, with Messi on the right and Sergio Aguero there playing down the middle as the centre forward in that front three. And I think there, that could be excellent. Now is the time to do this. The stakes are high, the pressure is on, you need goals, you need to score first, you need to go out and actually win this game on your own terms. A draw is not enough. Argentina right now are at that stage where they've got to go for it. And what do they have? They have very, very good attacking players. You've got Dybala, capable of scoring, capable of creating. You've got Messi, exactly the same there, and Sergio Aguero, who can certainly score goals. That front three could get Argentina over the line. And that's what I tend to think with Argentina sometimes. You look at their team, you look at the players they have, you look at the quality they have in those attacking areas. You've got Dybala, you've got Aguero, you've got Messi. You've got your front three there. You can then base your team around that front three. Basically, all you have to do there is set up your team to really benefit those three players. Get your fullbacks there giving some width. Get your centre-backs there just being concentrated, just being alive to the danger, and just get your midfield here doing the basics, doing the absolute basics, because those front three are top, top quality players. Dybala, Aguero, Messi, they are top, top quality. All you have to do there is just get the basics right. Just get the basic foundations right in midfield and defence, and I guarantee you there, that front three will take care of the rest. But to do that, Argentina have got to come out, they've got to be organised, they've got to have their roles there in midfield, you've got to have your roles there as the fullbacks, the centre-backs. You've got to get your organisation absolutely right there to benefit that front three, because Dybala, Aguero, Messi, as individuals, as a collective, they've not played an awful lot together, but they do have the quality that Argentina need to go out and win this game. But the big question is, will Scaloni call upon Dybala here? However, the second rumoured lineup is something very, very different indeed. The same there set of defenders in the team, but structured in a very different way, because what we could see from Argentina tomorrow is a back three or a back five, whichever way you want to play it. Tagliafico here, Otamendi and Petzela make it up essentially the three centre-backs. You've got then Acuna on this left-hand side, who can play as sort of wing-back, left midfielder, whatever you want to call it, with Casco there also on the right-hand side to provide backup there on the right wing. Also then, in midfield, you've got Lo Celso and Paredes. But that for me in that midfield area there looks really, really light. That's a midfield you can easily play through. It doesn't really create an awful lot. I don't really like the look there of that two-man midfield. It seems to me like Messi then is going to be made to drop really deep to actually get the ball. Then you're going to have Lautaro Martinez and Aguero very, very isolated. I prefer, no doubt about it, the first team that we saw. Include Dybala, roll the dice, take the risk. Because let's face it, up to this point, Argentina, what they've tried with Scaloni hasn't worked. What they need to do is something different. Get over the line in any way you can. Use some firepower. Use those quality forwards that you've got. Put them in the team and make it work. Because what you don't want in this kind of game, what you don't want in a must-win game where you need to score goals, is Messi in this position here. Give him a midfield. Give him there some defensive play, some structure. What you don't want is him dropping deep, leaving these players isolated, having no midfield, having nobody there to get him the ball, not in a crucial game. You want him in the productive areas in the final third to make this game happen. You need him to be in the areas to score the goals to get you through, and for that reason I would include him there in a front three, no defensive responsibility, a midfield behind him, somebody there to get him the ball to do the damage that he can do in this game. Because Argentina, they have to score, they have to win, the pressure is on. Can they do it? And I have to be honest with you guys and say that I have absolutely no idea when it comes to a score prediction. I really cannot call this game, and Argentina right now are so unpredictable, anything could happen. Because let's face it, they could win this game, they could go on to the knockout stages, and potentially, once they're in the knockouts, they could go deep in this tournament. It could genuinely happen. But at the same time, you wouldn't be all that surprised if Qatar came out tomorrow and not only drew with Argentina, not only stopped them from advancing, but actually beat them. That could genuinely happen too. At this stage, anything is possible, but for the sake of Messi, for the sake of Argentina here, I am going to go with a high-scoring game, because I do think tomorrow we're going to see goals from both sides. They're both going to go for it, because simply, Argentina have to do that. They've got to score some goals tomorrow to progress. I'm going to go Argentina 3, Qatar 2. It's going to be mental. It's going to be one heck of a rollercoaster ride. But hopefully, at the end of it, for Messi's sake, Argentina will book their place in the knockout stages. But please do let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, guys. How do you see this game going? Will Argentina make it? Let me know in the comments down below, and I'll be back here tomorrow for a match review. Straight after the game, I will be here to review it, and hopefully, in that match review, we will be celebrating on the side of Argentina. Let me know in the comments down below, what are your predictions? I'll see you soon. I'll see you soon, guys. But until next time, as always, it's Copa America!